Hello and welcome. In this video, we will go through how to upload the files into IDM using IAM. The possibility to upload the files into IDM is a very common request. In particular, the question is how to do it. We have several options to achieve the goal, like tools, manual, action, but the solution I'm going to present uses IAM. In the demo, we will see how to upload the files into IDM using an IAM file connector, connection point, and an IAM API connector. This is the diagram flow that describes the integration. On the left side, we have the files in the local server with the enterprise connector, while on the right side, we have the IAM API and the IDM in the cloud. If you're not familiar with what an enterprise connector is, please click on the link below. These are the sort of components involved in the integration. So as you can see, we have the enterprise connector, the IDM API suite, the file connection point, the IAM API connection point, and then we have the data flow, which combine everything as the integration. Now let's have a look one by one. To read the file, we need the enterprise connector, usually installed on the same server where are the files to be read, as shown in the screen. Also, we have the file connector connection point. Now, this connector uses the file template, as you see here, and notice that the file template linked to this connection point read file of type binary, and the file format is raw data, which is a bit different compared to the standard file template used by file connection, where you can read XML, JSON, TXT. And also we create a custom board, which is called the MyRawJS. This is the IO connection point that uses the standard IDM API suite. Also in the connection point, it's worth to notice the mapping of the request body for the API document. Last but not least, we need a script to format some attributes of the body that we need to pass to the body of the API, as I show in the screen here. One more check that we want to do is the presence of the document in one view. Let's do that. We click on the app switcher, we go to the IAM desk, we have the one view here, and if we search, you see that we don't have any document. Now let's activate the document flow and let's see that the document is moved from the local folder to the IDM. Let's activate the document flow. Let's have a look if the file is picked up by the file connector. You see here that the folder we have the Infor logo PNG. Now, in a while, we should pick it up, this file, and it should go to the archive folder. Done. Let's see now if the file has been uploaded to the IDM. There you go. We got a file in IDM. This concludes the demo. For more resources on Infor Document Management and the IAM, check the video description below. Thank you for watching.